Hi, welcome to this tour of historic and present-day Katherine. Katherine is a town situated 320 kilometres south of the capital city of Darwin, Northern Territory. It's the third largest settlement in the territory after Darwin and Alice Springs. Katherine's population is 6,500. An early shot of Katherine showing the railway. A clear view of the Katherine River. A Google shot of Katherine showing its layout. Katherine's early history rested on the pastoral industry. The Katherine Telegraph Station was finished in 1879. Early transport around Katherine. A donkey team hard at work. Fjording the Katherine River with bullocks. An early Katherine homestead. Springvale was the pastoral headquarters built in 1879. Early Katherine was primitive and rugged. An early view of the railway hotel in Katherine. The later railway hotel. Another early hotel, the commercial. Some views of the main street of Katherine. An early shot of the modern bridge through Katherine. The bridge today. Road trains commonly stop at Katherine. A modern shell road train crosses the bridge. A little bit frightening for tourists seeing books like this. We spent a week at the big 4G low-level caravan park. Bougainvillea in full bloom. It's a beautiful caravan park. Jamie outside a 1950s caravan and car. An early photo of low-level crossing. Beautiful views from the low-level crossing bridge. Dawn takes a photo. Aboriginal children at play. The river is very scenic and good for fishing. We take the excellent cycle path along the north side of the river into Katherine. A view of the river from the cycle path. Signs warning of fresh and saltwater crocodiles. An interpretive sign about the intense farming efforts during the war. We reached the Katherine Hot Springs with wheelchair access. This map shows the location of the hot springs. People relax in the water. I don't think it's all that. Very early architecture in Katherine. We pass a pre-primary center and look at the arc. Small children play in the pre-primary. We've reached the outskirts of town, the diggers. In town, the tourist industry is advertised by painting. My friend Jamie Wright is a keen fisherman. A sign warning of crocodiles. Main Street of Katherine, let's look around. Cattle, mining, defense, and tourism all play a major part in the economy of Katherine. Minerals produced in Katherine include lead, zinc, barite, and gravel.
It's Sunday and not many cars.
Boozing reaches an all-time high.
There is no sign of being a dry town when we went to the Katherine Hotel today. We went in.
Jamie and I head along the cycle path. Interpretive signs along the way describe bird life. It's a very scenic path. We pass some old ruins, dating perhaps. Jamie finds a 1912 penny hidden. What is it? I'm not really sure. We pass Maggie Bray's grave. She died in 1928. We learn from this sign that the original Katherine was on the north. The first Katherine began in 1907. A view of the Katherine River from the old railway bridge. We walk across the bridge and read about the historic railway. There's some steam train remains that we the steam train at the Katherine Railway Station. Jamie admires the train. The railway station was built in 1926. Construction of the bridge in 1926.
It was quite a major task. The bridge led to the rapid growth. The bridge today stands in disrepair. Its uses as a tourist attraction. An aerial shot showing the railway social protocol is posted beneath the bridge. In 2004, the GAN from Adelaide to Darwin commenced operation. The GAN stops near Katherine and is popular with tourists. This interpretive plaque talks about the many floods of the Katherine. Most of the year, during the dry season, Katherine River looks very peaceful. Who would expect that it can become a raging torrent? A state of emergency in 2006. The water under the old railway bridge. You believe the water rose 23 meters. A boy is trapped in a tree and attacked by a freshwater croc. Let's look at Nipmuluk National Park and Katherine Gorge. A remote, rugged and tough country, the gorge is dramatic. A helicopter flight up the gorge. Let's look at some still photos of the escarpments are amazing. Vertical cliff faces. The area is famous for its Aboriginal rock art. Crocodiles are a risk in the Katherine River. A freshwater crocodile sunning itself on a bank. It does look vicious. The waterfalls are worth seeing in the wet season. Not much in the dry season. Edith Fall. A lonely lizard seen on the way. Thanks for joining me on this tour of Katherine Gorges and historic Katherine and Katherine today. Have a good day.